Bonds Helix shoes are as stiff as previous models and they're built to the same high standards, but although the new around-the-foot retention system is innovative, the single boa closure doesn't give you the options of a double dial system. These shoes boast all of the features that Bond has become known for over recent years. First up, there's the bathtub-shaped chassis, or sole to you and me, that's made of unidirectional carbon fiber from Toray. It bends up around the sides of your foot, especially towards the rear where it extends to about 70% of the height of the shoe. One of the main reasons why you might consider these shoes is because of Bond's last, which determines the overall shape. Essentially, it's a cycle-specific last that's designed to be closer to the shape of a foot than others out there. I get on really well with Bond shoes because of this. Many people find that with Bonds, their toes aren't squashed together like they usually are, leading to improved comfort while pedaling. You also get a medial longitudinal arch support. You can see that the chassis is shaped on the instep to prevent overpronation and all of the problems that can result from that. Bond uses a proprietary material sandwiched in the upper to prevent stretch. There's absolutely none, and memory foam in the tongue and around the opening to provide comfort without retaining sweat or rainwater. The lining is faux suede while the outer layer is Duralite, as it is on the Vapor S, a composite material that's very hard wearing. I can tell you that for sure. It might look a bit scuffed after a scrape along the tarmac, but it'll probably survive. Overall, the Helix shoes offer many excellent features and they're built to Bond's distinctive shape, which will win them many fans, but although the under-the-sole cable routing can help to avoid pressure points, the single dial closure does mean you have less opportunity to fine-tune the fit than with a dual dial system.